All right.
Okay.
So today we are back with a very special reaction video. All of you have been requesting that we react to Angelina Jordan on Norway's Got Talent at the age of 7 years old.
Yep.
So that's what we're going to do today.
That's what we'll do. And I guess this was her first public audition on Norway's Got Talent.
Interesting.
And it was back in 2014. And it says that her version was based on the Billie Holiday version. So she sang Gloomy Sunday.
Mm.
I never heard of the song Gloomy Sunday.
Me either.
I have heard of Billie Holiday.
Yeah.
But again, not familiar with her work.
Yeah.
So as we usually do when we're not familiar with an artist or their song, we got to do some research.
Let's check her out.
So Billie Holiday was an American jazz and swing music singer, nicknamed Lady Day by her friend and music partner Lester Young. Holiday had an innovative influence on jazz music and pop singing. Her vocal style, strongly inspired by jazz instrumentalists, pioneered a new way of manipulating phrasing and tempo. She was known for her vocal delivery and improvisational skills. Improvisational skills, okay.
Throughout the 1930s and 1940s, Holiday had mainstream success on labels such as Columbia and Decca. By the late 1940s, however, she was beset with legal troubles and drug abuse. After a short prison sentence, she performed at a sold-out concert at Carnegie Hall. She was a successful concert performer throughout the 1950s with two further sold-out shows at Carnegie Hall. Because of personal struggles and an altered voice, her final recordings were met with mixed reaction, but were mild commercial successes. Her final album, Lady in Satin, was released in 1958. Holiday died of cirrhosis on July 17th, 1959. At age 44.
So she was born in 1915 and she died in 1959.
Yeah. And I know a few months ago I was just scrolling through Netflix and I saw I think it's a series called The United States versus Billie Holiday.
It's right here. Yep. Several films about her life have been released, most recently The United States versus Billie Holiday.
So they were coming after Billie Holiday.
Oh, look, look. Billie Holiday rose to fame in part due to her song Strange Fruit about lynching. You remember when Kanye West used the sample of Strange Fruit?
Yeah.
In, I think it was Blood on the Leaves. Very, very distinctive voice.
Yep.
Very painful, powerful voice she had in that song.
Basically, you know, the federal government put out a an operation against Billie Holiday, a sting operation.
So the federal government targeted the Strange Fruit singer with drug arrests.
In 1939, Billie Holiday rode the service elevator in a Midtown Manhattan hotel on her way to sing on stage. Of course, the hotel had a front door, but Holiday wasn't allowed to use it because she was black. Little did she know, this was just the beginning of the troubles that would follow her that night. Holiday stuck to her set list, including singing Strange Fruit, a hauntingly emotional song against lynching, with lyrics like Southern trees bear strange fruit, blood on the leaves, and blood at the root. Black bodies swinging in the southern breeze, strange fruit hanging from the poplar trees. Her self-described way of being able to sing like an instrument made the performance particularly effective. But that night, she received a warning from the Federal Bureau of Narcotics, the FBN, a government agency which lasted from 1930 to 1968. She was never to sing the song again. The link between the song and the anti-drug agency may feel disjointed, except that FBN Commissioner Harry Anslinger drew a direct correlation.
To Harry Anslinger, Billie Holiday was the symbol of everything that America had to be afraid of. Johann Hari, who wrote the book Chasing the Scream, The First and Last Days of the War on Drugs, told WNYC, She had a heroin addiction because she'd been chronically raped as a child. And she was trying to deal with the grief and the pain of that. And also she was resisting white supremacy. And when she insisted on continuing on her right as an American citizen to sing Strange Fruit, Anslinger resolved to destroy her.
There's a lot happening there.
Yeah. So she was more than an artist, that's for sure.
It's so interesting when you peel back the layers of artists in previous decades and generations. There's so much to learn about history.
Yeah, and how it's intertwined with the government of that time, the society, the social issues of the time.
Yes.
And how much of an impact musicians had on society.
Oh, yeah.
During these times. Look what it says, Jared. It says, in 1939, she rode the service elevator in a Midtown Manhattan hotel on her way to sing on stage. Of course, the hotel had a front door, but Holiday wasn't allowed to use it because she was black.
So she couldn't use the front door, but, you know, white people were coming to watch her perform.
Wow.
It's very, very ironic, but, you know, that the time period.
Yep. And this right here is Henry Anslinger. When Anslinger first took on the role in the new agency that was part of the Treasury Department, he was determined to eradicate all drugs everywhere. He had previously been part of the Department of Prohibition, but since the prohibition had been abolished, he was more determined than ever to take a strict stance on drugs.
So this is the war on drugs before the war on drugs. You know, this is the war on drugs we haven't learned too much about.
Oh, this is interesting. I'd never heard of any of this. It also says among his strategies was his belief that jazz music was a part of the problem. It sounded like the jungles in the dead of night. A memo he wrote said, while another said, unbelievably ancient, indecent rites of the East Indies are resurrected, and that the songs reek of filth. His agents even reported back to him that many among the jazzmen think they are playing magnificently when under the influence of marijuana, but they are actually becoming hopelessly confused and playing horribly. This is interesting, how the government can push back on what the people hear. Dude, this sounds like music at its purest form.
Yeah.
They said her voice sounds like an instrument.
Yeah.
She's expressing herself.
And I think after we listen to Gloomy Sunday, we need to check out Strange Fruit.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But let's jump into Gloomy Sunday. Billie Holiday, you can tell, you know, she's much more than just a singer.
Yeah.
She's an icon from her period in history.
Yep. Okay, so just real quick, a brief history of Gloomy Sunday. Gloomy Sunday, also known as the Hungarian Suicide Song, is a popular song composed by Hungarian pianist and composer Rezo Sures and published in 1933. The original lyrics were titled The World Is Ending and were about despair caused by war, ending in a quiet prayer about people's sins.
Gloomy Sunday was first recorded in English by Hal Kemp in 1936 with lyrics by Sam M. Lewis, and was recorded the same year by Paul Robeson with lyrics by Desmond Carter. It became well known throughout much of the English-speaking world after the release of a version by Billie Holiday in 1941. Lewis's lyrics referred to suicide, and the record label described it as a Hungarian suicide song. There is a recurring urban legend which claims that many people have committed suicide while listening to this song, particularly Hungarians.
Okay.
Wow.
So the song Gloomy Sunday became well known throughout much of the English-speaking world after the release of a version by Billie Holiday in 1941.
Yeah.
So
it's not her song. She sort of reconstructed it and released her own version of it.
Maybe she arranged it.
Maybe she rearranged it.
Rearranged it. All right, let's get into it. Gloomy Sunday, Billie Holiday.
And unfortunately, there is no music video or live performance that we could find.
Yeah.
So we have a lyric video of Gloomy Sunday by Billie Holiday.
Let's go.
My hours are slumberless. Dear, it's the shadows I live with are numberless. Little white flowers will never awaken you. Not where the black coach of sorrow has taken you. Angels have no thought of ever returning you. Would they be angry if I thought of joining you? Gloomy Shadows, I spend it all. My heart and I have decided to end it all. Soon there'll be candles and prayers that are said, I know. Let them not weep. Let them know that I'm glad to go. Death is no dream, for in death I'm caressing you. With the last breath of my soul, I'll be blessing you. Gloomy Sunday. Dreaming, in the deep of my heart, dear, darling, I hope that my dream never haunted you. My heart is telling you how much I wanted you.
A very sad song.
Yeah, the word that comes to mind for me is despair.
Despair, melancholy comes to my mind.
Introspective as well, like very aware that you are okay to go.
Mm.
But she said something about a dream, like it was all a dream in the end.
I mean, just sitting here, you know, this song doesn't make you... It didn't make me feel good.
Mm.
Right?
It made me wonder, first of all, what was the context of its creation?
Yeah.
Like what of Billie Holiday's version? Like, was it during the Great Depression?
Mm.
1940s? Was that?
1930s.
1930s was the Great
Depression? 1929.
That's the Great Depression era?
I believe so.
1941. It just sounded like, yeah, like a sad... time.
Yeah.
It sounded like sadness.
You know, just sitting here, obviously you can hear the talent in her voice.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she goes up and down. You know, she does a lot of different experimentation with her voice.
Yeah.
But yeah, that was a sad song.
Yeah. And I feel like her voice rattles.
Yeah. Yes.
At times it reverberates.
Yeah.
After she gets done singing like a high note. Caressing you.
Yes.
Like that's where I think the instrument, with, they said that her voice sounds like an instrument. That's what I thought of. Another thought I had was, wow, like, this is going to be a different song for Angelina Jordan to sing. Like, how is she going to arrange this?
I am very interested to see that.
Or what approach is she going to take to singing this song? Because it's very, very heavy and not a song that you leave someone with a good feeling.
Well, this is a song, I'm guessing, nobody just picks Gloomy Sunday as a song they want to sing.
Mm.
Right? I'm interested to see Angelina Jordan and the respect she brings to this song, you know? And whether or not she can elicit a different feeling inside of us when we listen compared to Billie Holiday.
That's a good point. That's a good point, because she seems to have that power.
Yeah.
Of, like, especially in Bohemian Rhapsody, which we listened to previously. Check that out if you haven't already. But she completely rearranged the song in a way that made it sound so different.
In a way that it made your soul tingle.
Right. Such a beautiful way. So I'm so interested to see how she's going to approach this one.
Yeah. All right. So you want to hop into some of these comments before we get into the video?
All right, let's read some.
Okay, so the first comment comes from Board Game Hype, and they write, "I never watched reaction videos until I saw yours. Now I watch yours all the time. Great stuff." Thank you very much, Board Game Hype.
Thank you. Wow. All right, so Darlene Adams says, "I am looking forward to the day as you go down the rabbit hole when you watch her Norway's Got Talent performances at age 7. Billie Holiday is one of my favorite singers. Angelina sings Gloomy Sunday. The first time I heard her, the video was recently released. I was blown away. I actually cried because Angelina's voice was such a shock. All I could hear was Billie Holiday. She also sang I'm a Fool to Want You at age 7 a cappella, and again at age 13 in the studio. Again, all you hear is Billie Holiday. I love how she embodies and respects every artist she covers." That's a common theme.
Yeah.
"I have watched her grow up since Norway's Got Talent, and every time I hear her, her voice is never the same. Every single song sounds so different with her voice, thus 1,000 voices. You two are absolutely amazing by listening to the original first, then to her. It's why I subscribe, because this is how it should be done with her songs if you are not familiar with the originals. She embodies their soul and makes you feel the music. As one of the NGT judges told her, you are music. She is music. She makes you feel the song, music. Thank you for another beautiful reaction."
Wow.
Darlene, thank you. And we completely agree that by listening to the original song, I mean, it's the only way to do it.
Yeah.
You know, it's the only way that we can fully appreciate what Angelina Jordan is doing. So thank you for your kind words.
Thank you, Darlene. All right. So a few more comments here. The next comment comes from Bruce Clark. Bruce writes, "Wow, wow, wow. Awesome. Your journey ahead will be exciting. I will be there. I love your format. And I am 81. Loved music my whole life. And Angelina is the one that I have enjoyed the most. She is 16 now, and even better, and growing, both voice and height." Wow. So this comment makes me happy.
Yeah.
And it makes me hopeful when we have Bruce, who is 81 years old, enjoying the performances and music of somebody who is 16 years old. And we're 26. So you got a wide variety of ages here enjoying music. That shows you that music is human. That shows you the power of music to touch the human spirit, regardless of how old somebody is, regardless of somebody's race, gender, class, regardless of all of that, music can touch the human spirit. I love it.
Yeah. Thanks, Bruce.
Thank you, Bruce. All right. And the last comment here comes from Denning Harden. Denning writes, I wanted to give you two some advice that will help you. On future reactions, don't change anything. You guys are spectacular. I truly enjoy every minute of your reactions. When I was first reading this comment, I was looking for Denning to provide us some good constructive criticism.
Right.
But I guess Denning has told us to not change anything.
We'll do our best, Denning. We appreciate it, man.
All right. We hope you all enjoy this video. And if there is anybody out there who has constructive criticism for things we could be doing or should be doing, or for how we can be better reactors, we want to hear that. Please put that in the comments and we'll do our best to read your comment.
So let's get into it.
All right.
Angelina Jordan, Gloomy Sunday, audition on Norway's Got Talent in 2014.
Første auditiondag går mot slutten, og for de yngre deltakerne kan vente til å bli lang. Heldigvis for Angelina både mamma, familie og venner med som støtte.
Jeg heter Angelina Jordan. Jeg 7 år. Jeg kommer fra Oslo. Jeg skal synge en sang som heter Gloomy Sunday fra Billie Holiday. Jeg har en kjempestor gjeng. Pappa og lillesøster, mormor og mamma. Jeg elsker å synge, og når jeg blir stor, så vil jeg være en superstjerne.
Oh, that's interesting. When she grows up, she wants to be a superstar. I want to know where that thought came from in a 7-year-old's mind.
She sounds like an old soul. Like, she sounds like a grandmother. If you close your eyes, she could sound like a grandmother speaking.
Yeah.
A wise soul.
Hvis dommerne sier ja, så blir jeg veldig glad. Da blir jeg sånn.
Andreas, jeg jobber med lyd. Skal du få den mikrofonen
der?
Du har
synget
mikrofonen før, ikke sant?
Kjempebra,
da vet du hva du skal gjøre.
Er du klar inne der?
Ja.
Ja. Ok.
That's her mother.
Yeah. She looks young.
Yeah.
Yeah. Er du klar inne der?
Ja.
Ja. Ok. Gå ut og gi dem jazz.
Hei, Sand.
Hei.
Hei, velkommen hit.
Takk.
Hva heter du?
Jeg heter Angelina Jordan.
Hvor gammel er du, da?
Jeg 7 år.
7 år, og hva det du skal gjøre for oss her i dag?
Jeg skal synge for dere.
Hvilken sang, da?
Gloomy Sunday fra Billie Holiday.
Ok. Oi. Da gleder vi oss, Angelina. Da kan du bare sette i gang når du er klar. Scenen er din.
Dear is the shadow I live
Real quick, before the judges speak, when she first started singing, she has this, it seems like she's always had this way of, like the people say, making her voice sound so similar to the original artist.
Yeah.
And a thought I had was, because I had said she sounded like an old soul.
Yes.
When she was just talking.
And those are the two words that were in my mind during this entire performance. Old soul.
But it makes me wonder, does she have an easier time at certain ages covering certain artists? Billie Holiday, you heard her voice when she was singing. Very instrumental, like they said. Instrumental sounding. And very, I don't know how to describe it.
Raspier,
but very like that 1940s.
Yes.
Vibe.
Are you saying because of her age and the way her voice,
yes,
develops and matures?
Yes.
Maybe at the age of 7, she's better able to cover a Billie Holiday song than she is now, or vice versa.
I'm wondering.
Yeah, that's an interesting thought.
Because her just speaking at this age sounded like an older soul. Like she's got a deeper voice.
Yeah.
You know, than most 7-year-olds.
Yeah. I think for me, what's most impressive about this performance is that, again, she probably could have came out here on stage and performed a much easier song that would have demonstrated her true vocal ability.
Yeah.
However, she performed one of the most difficult songs, and she made it sound as if Billie Holiday had been reincarnated.
As if Billie Holiday was singing it.
Yes.
Yes.
You know?
Yep.
And it's not a loud, boisterous performance.
Yeah.
It's very subtle because she's trying to capture the essence of Billie Holiday. That's her intent here, Jordan.
That's right. She's trying to capture the essence of Billie Holiday.
Yes. And you can see it in her, how self-assured she is. You know, how self-confident she is, that she's not going out here to try to be somebody she's not.
Yeah.
She's going out here to respect her craft and to deliver something to these judges that they've never heard before. And that's Billie Holiday in a 7-year-old's body. That's what's most impressive here.
Yeah, let's see what they say.
Oh, give me some of that.
Angelina?
Ja?
Jeg tror at du
en old gammel soul.
Sjel som har levd mange liv. Du synger helt fantastisk. Jeg fikk gåsehud helt fra starten av. Jeg har ikke egentlig mistet det. Jeg er litt tom for ord her, egentlig.
Ja, det var helt fantastisk å sitte og høre på deg. Dette var virkelig, altså. Du er jo musikk.
Takk.
Ja.
Vet du hva jeg tenker om deg? Jeg tenker at du er født til å synge. Og jeg vil si at foran oss her, folkens, så har vi ei stjerne.
Noen ganger når man er voksen og man ser et barn som synger, så forstår man ikke helt hvordan det går an. Fordi at du synger på en sånn måte som man tror at man blir nødt for å være voksen, og kanskje til og med ganske voksen, for å gjøre. Vet du hva sangen handler om?
Ja. Det handler om en trist søndag.
Det gjør det. Jeg kjente den triste søndagen. Det var fantastisk å høre på deg. Virkelig fint.
Da stemmer vi, folkens.
Tusen, tusen takk.
Du synger helt vidunder og vakkert.
Tusen takk.
Hvor har du det fra? Snakk om å bli blown away.
Ja, det er det beste jeg
har sett. Hørte du med raspen? Det høres ut som jenta har drukket whisky siden hun kom.
Det var fantastisk.
That must be her grandmother. Wow.
Men sånne ting der kan ikke bli lært. Det er sånne ting som du er født med. Og hun hadde det bare.
Hun likte jazz. Det er ingen andre barn som liker jazz. Men hun liker jazz, og hun synger jazz. Som en gud.
Is your father?
Jeg sang om en trist søndag, men dette er en glad dag.
On to the
tusen
next one.
Tusen takk, Holmikum! Nå kommer det
kåre! Fantastiske! Virkelig, altså!
Was that her father who said, you know, she wants to sing jazz when other kids don't want to sing jazz?
I think that was. And please correct us if we're wrong. I think that was her father.
Yeah, that's what's going on here. She wants to sing jazz, and she wants to sing various genres of music that other kids don't want to go anywhere near.
And a lot of people have said that drive to sing jazz and specific types of songs comes from her grandmother playing songs for her.
Yeah.
And basically, you know, exposing different artists to her.
I love it.
But the choice to sing this song.
Look, do you know what that song's about?
It's about a sad Sunday.
It's about a sad Sunday. That's probably the most concise definition you can find.
Yeah.
You know, it's evident. She does her research about each song that she performs. And, you know, she digs deep into the history of the song, the history of the artist, I assume, and what she can do to best emulate and make better, if possible, that song.
Again, she studies.
Yeah.
To choose a classic song, an important song, a heavy song, from a Black American woman.
Yes.
A Black American musician.
Yep.
An icon. Doesn't just happen. That's an intentional choice, and that is, I think, what is the most powerful and important thing here.
And I think what we may be missing here is that she performed this song in English, right? And while they're all speaking Norwegian, I believe, I have to think that impressed the judges as well.
Well, I mean, they seem to know what the song was about, at least the one guy.
But again, music travels beyond barriers, beyond language barriers, right? True music that touches your soul does not matter whether it is, you know, sang in English, Norwegian, Spanish. It does not matter.
You know what's so beautiful about this? I wouldn't have went out of my way to listen to anything Billie Holiday.
Yeah.
Or anything Screamin' Jay Hawkins.
Yes.
Or really anything Queen.
Yes.
I think that's the most beautiful thing about this, because a 7-year-old, you know, Angelina Jordan, at all these different ages, at her young ages, is putting us onto important artists we should appreciate, artists that everybody should appreciate.
Absolutely.
And I think that's what I find most beautiful, I think, about this whole thing.
Absolutely. And I forget exactly what the comment said, but I read a comment that somebody wrote that said, the new music is in the past.
Meaning,
you want to hear some new music? Travel into the past. You want to hear some new sound, some new voice, some some music that you've never heard before, dive deep into the past.
And again,
that's what I feel like we're doing, Jordan.
Yes. Oh,
think about it for a minute, right?
Yeah.
Etta James.
Etta James. I forgot about Etta James.
Screamin' Jay Hawkins. Billie Holiday. Queen. You know, artists and musicians that, as you just said, we would never go out of our way to, you know, try to listen to their music or learn more about them. However, Angelina Jordan has caused us to do that.
Mm.
You know, that's the beauty of what she can do.
Mm.
You know, she can provide a musical education to us lay people, to us people in the 21st century.
Yeah.
You know, that's the beauty of it, is that, you know, she can bring the past to the present, you know, and inspire people to appreciate music that they no longer hear on a daily basis. And she'll perform it for you herself.
How much music out there is there that we have just no idea about, that we should know about, that is life-changing, that can change our lives? Literally,
look,
can give us life,
yes,
on a daily basis by listening to this music from previous generations.
There's two points here. One, there will never, ever be a shortage of music to listen to.
Mm.
You know, as is the case with many other things, there will never be a shortage of music, of good music to listen to. That's one. Two, there is music of the past, the present, and the future.
Mm.
Right? One of those categories gets the least attention. What is it?
It's obviously the past.
It's music of the past. And, you know, there was a time in history where we didn't have devices that are capable of capturing and recording music.
Mm.
So it had to be transmitted from generation to generation via performance.
Yeah, and then via records and
written
tapes.
You know?
Yeah, no, that's true. That's true.
But now, even with the plethora of ways to capture and record music, I still think the entire world does not appreciate music of the past as much as we should.
Yeah. I mean, we are the biggest, we're the biggest culprits of that. That's,
yeah.
I mean, this is amazing. Going into this, you think you have an idea of who an artist is, Billie Holiday, you have no idea until you dig in, and we have Angelina Jordan to thank for that.
Yeah.
So this was another different experience. This was a great performance. I think every single one of her performances are great.
And again, this is in many ways where her journey began.
Yeah, that's right. What they
in
say.
The, in the public arena.
Mm-hmm.
So it's great to see, you know, have some context at where Angelina Jordan started from, you know, and as we start to listen to some of her covers and performances later in her, you know, teenage years, I think we're in for a beautiful ride.
Yeah, can't wait.
All right, everybody. Thank you all for watching. We hope you enjoyed this reaction. It was definitely a different mood than our last reaction, but, you know, still incredible nonetheless. You will want to come back next week. We have a very, very special reaction video on its way next week. And we hope that everybody comes back to watch that.
We'll see you next week.
Peace.